Everyone, in this video I wanted to do a quick share of one of my favorite workflows for teaching math right now online, and that is a combination of Google Slides with Pear Deck and virtual manipulatives. Here's how it works. So to get started, I have a blank Google Slide, and I have a number of students working on place value right now. So on my blank Google Slide, I'm going to have students build the following number. And let's do 24. Go ahead and make all this a little bit bigger. All right. So that's one slide. And then I'm going to go to Pear Deck. Now, Pear Deck is an add-on. If you don't have it already installed, you can go to Get Add-ons and install it. They do offer a free trial with all the features, and then there is a limited version that is free following that free trial. So this is where you can add a variety of different questions. I do have the upgraded version here, so you're seeing all the options. And I'm going to choose website. And here's where you can paste a website. Now, not all websites are going to work, but one of my favorites to use for math right now is this one, the Math Learning Center. And they have a variety of different apps. They have a variety of different apps that are available on different devices, including the web. And they're all based on conceptual understanding. So I'm going to use this number pieces and open web app, and that's going to give me this link. So I'm going to copy this URL and paste it here. And now this is going to be embedded next to my slide. So I'm going to update slide, and Pear Deck adds this banner at the bottom. Now, if I want to do a variety of examples for this, the neat thing about Pear Deck is I can just go ahead and do a right click or two finger click on this first slide, duplicate it, and now we're going to build 72. So I have the slides I'm going to use for my small group. You can click on Start Lesson, and you do have both choices in the full version. I'm going to choose Instructor Paced Activity because we're going to do this live in a meet. And it's going to give you this code. I don't recommend having students join this way. It's going to take too long. I'm going to copy this link, drop it in the chat. Kids click on it. They verify their email, and they are in. So I'm going to be a student now and paste in that link. Pear Deck always starts with this question. Students can choose their smiley or skip. And this is what I love from the student perspective. So students see what I want them to do. They don't have to split screen their device. They don't have to listen to directions. They don't have to remember something that they wrote down. And now they can build the number. And I like this virtual manipulatives because it's just super straightforward. And there's my 24. Notice you have all these options down here. They can even do text and write something. Two tens plus four ones. So you can add different things to it. And the neat thing here is that this is also shareable. So if kids click this image, they can get a copy link that then they can attach to Google Classroom or whatever your system is. They could take a picture. So there's just a lot of different options here for students. Found that this takes very little bandwidth. And if they want to refresh, you do have this little circle icon hiding behind Perry. You can click it, clear your work. Yes. And that's going to be important because as the teacher progresses to the next slide, it's not automatically going to clear their work. I'm using this as practice for students because they don't necessarily have those manipulatives at home to model place value and various computation strategies at that concrete level. Now, from the teacher side, they go ahead and start class if they want to see what the students are doing. They can open up the dashboard in their new window, and this is what they're going to see. They see one student in. So when they open this embedded link, it's going to take them to the blank thing. So I am using this in combination of GoGuardian so I can see student screens. So if you have a tool such as GoGuardian Teacher or Hapara or some of the other similar apps that allow visibility of student screens, I don't spend any time in the Pear Deck teacher dashboard once I get students working when I'm using this website feature. So I'm finding this method for students of creating this split screen for them so they can model different numbers with the virtual manipulatives is working better than using Google Slides. Or I was finding there was a delay for a number of my students due to connectivity. But just remember, if you are using this method, you don't have visibility of student screens within Pear Deck. So it is going to rely on either another tool external where that gives visibility of student screens, or having students go ahead and share a copy of their work. So if you learned something new, give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing for future videos. Until next time, bye everyone.